I'm Michael Studinger, and I'm the project scientist for Operation IceBridge. In the particular upcoming campaign, we will focus on measuring ice surface elevations over Antarctica with a laser scanner that we have mounted on the DC-8 aircraft. And we will also look into measuring the surface elevation and surface characteristics of the sea ice that surrounds Antarctica and the Southern Ocean. Since we have this opportunity with a big aircraft that can carry many different instruments, we not only measure the ice surface elevation, but we have also ice penetrating radar instruments on the aircraft that allow us to actually look through the ice, find out how thick the ice is over the interior of Antarctica. This is something we need to know in great detail in order to develop better ice sheet models that will allow us to characterize how much sea level will rise in the next decades. About the time we started flying in Antarctica last year in October, ICESat stopped collecting data. The follow-up mission ICESat-2 will be launched in 2015. In order to fill this gap, NASA has launched Operation IceBridge. We are looking back through 10 years of weather history to come up with a certain estimate of how many flights, depending on the availability of crew and other things, we can possibly accomplish in a certain time window. And if we accomplish 90%, we would be really very satisfied.